While we're looking at the skies, if you love space and stargazing, you're in for a treat this weekend. Hundreds of shooting stars will be whizzing across the night skies as the Perseid Meteor shower peaks. But what's the best way to spot it? Well, de Graaf caught up with astronomer Dr. Renske Smith to get some tips.
Hey, Renske.
Hey, de Graaf.
Renske, I think I'm now ready to be a top stargazer, but I'm going to need some top tips.
So first of all, always think of the weather, because we're in the UK, most of the time there's just clouds above. So check, you know, the weather forecast. And two, think about light pollution. So it's a lot easier to see stars away from the city because the city has so many lights. So for example, on a campground. But even if you just have your balcony or your garden, you can still see a lot of stars. The main thing is that you turn off all the lights in the house, all the lights away, and make sure that your eyes adjust. It can take up to 30 minutes, half an hour, for your eyes to fully see all the stars. Obviously, if you're waiting for half an hour outside, you need something to keep you warm, good jacket or maybe a sleeping bag, comfy chair, that's important. And then, yeah, just enjoy all the beautiful things. If you do want to use some tools, you can buy a telescope, but even if you just have like your phone to take a picture, we can do a long exposure, so where the phone takes a long time to take a picture. So you need to make sure it's very still. So it's either on a standard or you put it down somewhere. And a really nice thing to photograph is Orion's nebula. It's a constellation. So you see three really bright stars in a line. And that's the belt of Orion. And on the top, you might see three stars that form the shoulders and the head of Orion. And then two stars below that might be his legs. And then off the belt, there's the sword of Orion, as it's called. And in the center of that sword is a fuzzy blob. And that's where new stars are being born right this moment. And these young, very hot stars, they're illuminating the gas cloud they're born from. And that gives really pretty colors. So that is definitely one to photograph.
Wow, Renske, I think now I have become a stargazing pro. I'm going to put some of those tips to the test.
Yeah, let's go.
Oh, look, a shooting star.
No, that's an airplane.
Oh, my bad.